The best infrastructure is invisible, and we've been really working hard to create an invisible infrastructure that helps support people doing what they do best in the creative community. So creating art spaces, helping to foster the growth of First Fridays, these are all really important things, and I think in the future people will take for granted that we've always had these wonderful things.
In many ways, Phoenix and Scottsdale, the whole area has been a canvas that's already laid out and stretched and something that you can build upon and paint upon. And the people around it are just amazing, and they're very motivated themselves.
The creative community in the Valley is by far its greatest asset. And the more we can do to help grow that, the happier we're going to be. It's just an incredible community of people. It's a tremendous extended family of people that we would do anything we can to support.
I definitely see that because of the city we are, the city we've become, that, and I'm watching this next generation stay here and get involved, that there's opportunity for them to have a voice in politics. And I see the arts having a large presence in how our cities unfold and what they become.
We're following behind communities like Chicago, New York, Los Angeles, but Phoenix should be on the list of places where arts and culture are thriving. And we see the possibilities for that to continue to grow in that direction. I think back 10 years ago, before there was the Scottsdale Museum of Contemporary Art, and that's been about the same time frame that we've been involved in downtown Phoenix and helping foster the creative community there. And seeing both of these things grow up over the last 10 years, it's remarkable. It's it's something that we couldn't have imagined 10 years ago, and we're here today, and we're thrilled to be a part of it.
Thank you.